Welcome back down to my basement. It's Dan here once again. And this cool little chap is the Italia Imola. And this is known as the IMB4. And there's also a 5-string model available. Now, this little chap here, let's flip the neck over and we'll have a look at the back of the headstock. Straight away, we have maple neck with 4 open gear Wilkinson tuners. These are the VJ350 tuners. Really nice smooth action on those. Nice and lightweight. Two aside on an angled headstock. So no string tree to get in the way. Let's have a closer look at that. So round we go. Onto that, we've got ourselves a rosewood fretboard. And as you can see, it's naked, so no dots here. But just to let you know, there are dots on the top of the neck as well, so we can see your place markers. But I like this kind of completely spotless fretboard. Very, very nice. Fretboard, very, very nicely rounded at the edges, and the frets are neatly installed. I can feel them just a little bit on the edge of my fingers there, but that's no problem at all. Rosewood fretboard, as I said, coming down onto the actual body itself. Straight out of the box, this bass was spot on in tune, so that's good news, isn't it? We've got ourselves a nice big black pick guard here, which is taking up a great part of the body, but actually I like it because there's a bit of tasteful design going on here. So fresh out of the box, I've not even taken the plastic wrapper off the pickguard there, so obviously when you take that off it's going to be even shinier, so very nice indeed. Love this, we've got this kind of like semi-hollow type body here, I can put my fingers in there. Bodywood is Carina, and we've got this really, really nice sunburst finish. Do you know what, let's turn the bass over, let's have a look at the back, and we can see that finish a bit clearer. There we go, look at that, really nice. Kind of like nice sort of like almost cherry sunburst kind of thing going on. Bolt on neck, as you can see here. Over we go. Back to the main instrument again. Wilkinson pickups and Wilkinson bridge. Perfectly functional. Do the job just brilliantly, and sound very, very good as well. I've had a quick zoom through all the settings before we started recording, and hey, yeah, as you'll hear in a moment, it sounds really, really good. Electronics, all passive, 2 volume controls and a master tone control here. And do you know what I like? This is just a small detail. I like that the tone control is just out the way. It's a smaller control. And it's, you know, I tend not to hit the tone control a great deal. I sort of set up a sound on my own gear and then tend to use outboard effects or the actual EQ on the amplifier to tweak it as I need to. But if you're kind of like a tweaker, then you'll be able to grab hold of this without hitting any controls by mistake. Front mounted jack socket into the pickguard itself. Let's get on and hear the pickup selections. So tone all the way open, so you're getting the full richness of these pickups. And I'm going to wind back the bridge pickup, so we're just listening to that front pickup. I'm just going to turn the bass around a little bit. Okay, here we go then. So my intro, I played a little bit of pick, fingerstyle, and a little bit of slap, so you can hear some of the brighter sounds from the instrument. I'll do the same again. Okay, so here we go. Let's see what happens. Here we go. That's really cool, actually. You can hear almost like a precision bass kind of sound in there. That's nice. Fingerstyle, here we go. Thank you. whilst we're here, let's wind that tone control back as well. So all the way off, here we go, pick style. Old school, kind of a little bit murky, a little bit for those nice sort of groovy bass lines where you don't want to impact on the rest of the band. Not bad at all. Nice, nice bit of a low mid-range there. Okay, so let's have a listen to that back pickup and do pretty much the same again. All the way open, pick to begin with. Plectrum work, I suddenly decided that I was in almost like a James Bond theme there. I like that sound which is coming out of that back pickup. Okay, let's roll off the tone control. So this is all the way off. Here we go. Again, with a pick work, it sounds really, really nice. Now what I'm going to do is, just to cover both bases, if you excuse the pun, I'm going to set the tone control at 12 o'clock with both pickups on, so we can get that sort of in-betweeny sort of sound. And I'll very, very quickly run through pick, fingers and slap work for the last time. Here we go. Very nice, actually. I think I just found a sweet spot on the controls there. Again, this bass really wants me to use a pick. It's got a great sound for that. Whether or not if that's your bag, then it doesn't matter. Kind of, it's whatever you're going to find exciting in this instrument. But it's funny how it's almost I'm being urged to play in that particular style. It seems to suit it, and it feels very cool, actually. I like this bass. I like it because it's not your average precision bass or jazz bass. Even though we have the jazz bass pickups on there, it looks different, and it kind of makes me play different, more differently as well. So, very, very cool. It comes available in black and honey sunburst and two-tone sunburst that we have here. And as I said, all passive electronics, Wilkinson hardware, really, really ultra light. It seems to balance quite well, actually, considering we've got this sort of offset design. Very, very cool. I like it. What more can I say? I'm going to add some more information into the written review as usual. But for now, I'm off to go and play some more with it. This is the Italia Imola bass. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you again soon.